My name's Fiona Spence and I play Vera Bennett in Prisoner. She's also known as Vinegar Tits. And I hope you enjoy this episode. It's 212 and the prisoners are getting up to their usual skullduggery and I'm trying to stop them, which is something that happened a lot on Prisoner. One of the things that the prisoners kept doing is, how can we get round Vera in this episode? And I was always trying to stop them, so it caused quite a lot of amusement for the prisoners and absolutely no amusement for me.
Police.
Oh, only mad dogs and Englishmen guard on a night like this. Oh, it doesn't matter, does it? We aren't going anywhere.
No, no, there's anybody else.
She's my daughter.
What?
Laurie is my daughter.
Oh, bloody hell. We really have made it blue, haven't we?
Yeah, I'm sorry.
You're sorry? We've been your judge and jury.
Yeah, well, I should have told you sooner, I know.
Well, why didn't you? I mean, that's something you should be proud of.
Well, I'm not exactly. You see, a lot of my friends in here, like Lizzie and Doreen, they had their kids taken away from them for one reason or another. And you had your kid taken away from you. Well, I gave away mine. I gave up Laurie for adoption.
Well, what kind of lousy friends do you think we are? We're not that bad, Jude. We would have understood.
That's what Laurie said.
Well, there you go. She knows us better than you do.
I'd still like it kept quiet.
With respect, Jude, I disagree. I think it's going to cause trouble.
Why?
Well, when she had a go at Doreen, I told her to scram, but she wouldn't back down. The kid's got guts. I reckon we're going to have to watch those two like hawks.
Where is she now?
Which one?
Well, I know where Laurie is. Where's Doreen?
I don't know.
But if she pulls another silent number like she pulled on Margot.
Yeah, come on. Like I thought. The knife she took from Margot, it's gone. Where's Doreen?
Who cares?
Listen, could you just keep out of trouble? I don't want any bad blood between you and Doreen.
She started it.
And if you're not very careful, she's going to finish it.
What are you talking about?
Keep an eye on the kid, will you?
Oh,
please?
I'm writing a letter.
Never mind about that now.
But it's to say.
Oh, listen, ladies, I don't need anyone to look after me. Oh.
Why can't Judy look after her? She's been rushing around like a mother hen ever since the kid came in.
Oh, leave Judy out of this.
Well, I'm not a bloody wet nurse.
Will you shut up, the pair of you? Okay, you've had a blue with Doreen, right?
So what?
So she's got a knife.
She wouldn't.
Well, she better keep away from me then.
I don't give a stuff about you, but I do about Doreen. And I don't want her to get into any more trouble.
Thanks a lot.
You just stay put and shut up. And you keep an eye on her and don't let Doreen come within a bull's roar of her, all right?
Who does she think she is, ordering people around like that?
Never you mind who she thinks she is. She runs this place, so you just do as you're told, young lady.
Oh, yes, ma'am.
Listen. If B tells me to do something, I do it. So you just sit down and shut up.
Be bored silly, you mean?
Well, better than getting a knife in your back, isn't it?
Oh, Doreen's so stupid, she wouldn't know what to do with it.
Listen, we're looking after you. Now, how do you spell nasturtium?
Where's Julie? She's gone to the tut. I'm lining the store.
Oh, that's a pity. She was prettier.
Well, you fancy your chances, do you?
Well, you never know. Key box, please. Listen, have you heard the weather report?
Yeah, there's no change until tomorrow.
Damn. There goes my run tonight.
Yeah, what's all this get fit business anyway?
Well, you've got to look after yourself.
Yeah, I can see where you need it. I mean, a man of your age.
Get off it.
Anyway, you shouldn't let a little thunderstorm get in your way.
Why, do you want to come with me, do you?
Maybe tomorrow.
Yeah, that's the trouble. Might be too late.
Why's that?
Well, one of the reasons why I'm running is I'm trying to find this missing witness for Michelle Parks.
Now, wait a minute, you're the one that told me not to get involved with the prisoners.
Well, this is different. Michelle's...
Oh, I see. It's Michelle now, huh?
Seriously, mate. You were chatting up a known criminal. I'm just trying to help Parks prove that she's innocent.
They all say they're innocent when they come in here, you know that.
Well, this one's different. I think so, anyway.
Yeah, maybe you're right. The trial comes up tomorrow, doesn't it?
Yeah. Yeah, I suppose it's a bit of a long shot. Oh, well, See
you. Yeah, see you.
You're much prettier than he is, Julie.
Really?
Any luck? No sign of her, you. Oh, well, you don't think Doreen's going to do anything?
Look, Doreen will be a spiteful little bitch when she wants to be, and she's got it in for Laurie, and she's got a knife. Judy, I don't know.
Benny, what are we going to do?
Well, is it fine? That's all. At least we know where Laurie is. Come on.
What's on?
No, Dor, don't do it.
Do what?
It's not worth it. Love, leave her alone.
What are you talking about?
She didn't mean it. She's only new here. She didn't mean what she said. Now, did you, love?
Oh, look, I don't need you to fight my battles. I can look after myself.
Oh, I'd like to see you try.
Oh, Doreen, you give me the irrits.
You'll get yours, you talking
no,
old
no,
bitch.
No, Dor, it's not worth hanging for.
What?
B said that you'd got a knife and that
her?
You'd got
her? Oh, God, I wouldn't waste me energy.
Doreen, where is it?
What?
A knife. Margot's knife. Where is it?
In our cell where I hid it.
Oh, no, it's not. We've looked.
Well, you better look again, hadn't you?
Oh, don't get cheeky. What are you up to?
Nothing. Anyway, who said I took it?
I did.
Oh, I see. You thought I was going to cut Laurie up, didn't you? Well, that's real nice. You can really tell who your
where
friends are.
Where is Laurie?
She was here a minute ago. She must have gone to her cell.
What have you done?
Nothing. Just getting a bit of my own back. Well, why not? You've treated me like dirt ever since she turned up.
There's a reason.
It better be a flaming good one.
It is.
Oh, come on, Jude, tell her.
I'll be.
Look, what's the point of having us bitching amongst ourselves? She isn't going to do any harm, love. Come on.
All right. Laurie's my daughter.
Oh, bull.
Oh, Jude, how could she be?
Well, it's true. I mean, I haven't seen her since she was a baby. She tracked me down and got herself put in here to be with me.
Bee?
It's true.
Oh, Jude, I'm so happy for you.
Oh, God.
What have you done?
See, I thought that Judy fancied her and, well, I set up this sort of surprise in her cell. It's a nasty
one. Oh, Doreen!
Doing here? Bennett, it was an accident. It was all my fault.
Yeah, look, it was a bit of a mix-up, and she didn't mean it for you.
Where are you taking
for a long stint in solitary, not that it's any of your business.
But it wasn't meant for you.
If only you'd listen.
I'm sick of your lies, and I'm sick of your explanations. Now get back to the recreation room, or you'll all be locked in your cells.
But you can't.
You heard me. Now get moving. Now come with me.
Oh, she can't do that. Laurie doesn't deserve that.
Well, don't worry. She'll be all right. You'll see.
Oh, I don't know. I think Vinegar's really flipped her lid.
Well, you must admit, Vera looked real funny.
Yeah, that serves it right.
I wish I'd been there to see it happen.
It's not funny. Laura's going to be stuck in the pound for God knows how long. Now, we got to do something.
Yeah, she's right. Miss Bennett certainly isn't going to listen to reason, not in the mood she's in.
Well, what screw ever listened to reason?
Yeah, well, Dave-o might, and it's worth a try, isn't it?
Oh, I knew you'd be trouble the moment I heard you were Brian's daughter.
You leave her out of this.
I suppose you've inherited her other instincts. The same perverted attraction to other women. Are you like that too? Well, are you?
Why? Do you fancy me?
Don't be disgusting.
What's so disgusting about finding someone to care for? Even if it is another woman.
I knew it. Just the same as your mother.
Well, it couldn't have worked out better if I'd planned it.
Yeah, we should start calling her Soapy Tits now.
Pity about Laurie, though.
Yeah, that was bad luck.
Cool, you soon changed your tune, didn't you?
Yeah, well, I didn't know, did I? I mean, if Judy had said that Laurie was her kid, but I just thought she was some young spunk she had the hots for.
Well, you can't go by appearances, just like me and Sid.
What has that got to do with anything?
Well, some people might think that we're bubonic friends. Whereas, really...
Really? You got the hots for him and can't wait to get him away for a dirty weekend.
Good, you got a dirty mind sometimes, B. Me and Sid, it's different.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Would you, Lizzie? I mean, you know, with you and Sid being, well, more mature, would you, play funny buggers?
It's for me to know and for you to find out. I'm just saying, you can't judge a book by its cover like Jude and Laurie. Yeah, well, she really had me fooled.
But what I still don't see is that Judy being the way she is, what's she doing having a kid?
Well, look who's talking.
What do you mean?
Well, you've had a kid, but that didn't stop you from getting sweet on Frankie, though, did it?
Suppose so, but that was different. Have been rotten to him, though. Mm. But if Judy had just said
something... Yeah, well, you have a word to Davo in the morning.
Oh, why me?
Who else?
You reckon she'd listen?
Oh, I suppose so. She's in a good mood. You could always try a bit of soft soap.
Just like Vera. Oh, God, she looked funny. I nearly wet myself.
Well, her boyfriend wasn't around.
Oh, now I really could spend a dirty weekend with him.
Oh, Lizzie, you couldn't, could you?
Yeah. Will you all be up on a charge?
Dreaming of your girlfriend, Bryant. It's a good story, isn't it? Telling everyone that vicious little lesbian is your daughter so that you can share a cell with her.
She's not like that and you know it.
Oh, isn't she? She's got all your other qualities, if she is your daughter.
She doesn't know anything about me or what I am.
I wouldn't be too sure about that.
You wouldn't tell her. You couldn't. Not even you could be such a bitch.
There was no need to tell her. She already knew.
How? How did she know?
Pretty obvious, I would have thought. I happened to mention it to her. And she said she already knew. After all, it takes one to know one.
Morning.
Is it?
Hi, Julie. Shouldn't you have knocked off by now?
I'm waiting for Mrs. Davidson. I've got a report for her. There was a disgraceful performance by the prisoners last night.
Oh, that bad, huh?
I didn't expect much sympathy from you.
Mm. Listen, has Parks gone to court yet?
Yes, a few minutes ago.
Damn.
Another one of your hearts and flowers cases.
I'm just trying to help.
Trying quite hard, I hear.
Well, I think it'd be a shame for her to miss out on the national athletics team if she's innocent.
If.
And I get a bit tired of people who judge others without knowing all the facts.
It's a pity that you don't extend that same sympathy to some of the staff as well as the prisoners.
I do. To most of them.
That's the prisoner's mail.
That's right.
Well, you can't just let it go through.
Yes, I can.
They can get away with anything in here.
So I set it up for Laurie, and, well, I don't know, somehow she must have found out, and she got into the cell all right, and then Vera, Miss Bennett, came along and copped the lot.
A bucketful of soap powder.
Well, it wasn't quite a bucketful. Nearly, but.
All over her.
Oh, yeah. She looked awful. Well, she thought Laurie had done it. The next thing I know, she's carting her off to the pound. Well, it wasn't Laurie's fault, Mrs. Davidson, it was mine. And so I thought I'd just come along here and explain it all to you so that you could let her out. You will, won't you? Let her out.
Needless to say, Doreen, I do have some knowledge of the incident. What I do not understand is why you would play such a trick on Laurie.
Well, I was Judy's friend until she came along.
And you were jealous?
Well, I got chucked out of Judy's cell and I thought that they... Well, heck, how was I supposed to know she was Judy's daughter?
I'm glad you've shown such responsibility in owning up. However, a sentence of 2 days has been ordered by the officer in question, and I will not countermand that.
But she didn't do it.
So I propose to release Young, and you will serve the remainder of her sentence. Furthermore, you will apologize to Miss Bennett for your behavior.
Say sorry? To her? Oh, you got to be kidding. I'm not flaming saying I'm sorry to her.
Burns?
Well, I can't.
Very well. Then you and Young will be confined to solitary.
Mm?
Miss Bennett is in reception. I have to go there now, so I will take you with me. Come along. Miss Bennett, Burns has something to say to you. Doreen?
Yeah, well, I'm sorry about what happened last night in Laurie's cell and, Well, it was all my fault, and I'm saying I'm sorry.
Well?
You can't let it go just like this.
I think she did it rather nicely.
It's a trick to get that girl out of solitary.
Burns is serving the remainder of the punishment you ordered.
Bryant put you up to this, didn't she?
No, Miss Bennet, I don't think so.
Could I speak to you privately, please?
Miss Bennet, a prisoner has just apologized to you, and I do not believe she has received an answer.
Very well. I accept your apology.
Mr. Harrison, would you take Burns to solitary and release the prisoner Young at the same time, please?
Yes, Mrs. Davison. Okay, Burns, come on.
I hope this will be an end to it.
Okay, Young, out you get.
But...
come on.
But I thought I had 2 days.
Yeah, well, Burns has taken your place.
Why?
Told Mrs. Davidson about what happened. I didn't think it was your fault. I didn't think it was fair.
I didn't think you liked me.
Well, who says I do?
Oh, come on, this is not a social club. Come on, here you go.
All right. See ya.
Yeah, see ya.
Yes, Lizzie, what is it?
I'd like to have a word with you in private, Mrs. Davidson. Women's talk.
Oh, of course. Well?
It's about Sid Humphrey.
Yes, Lizzie?
Well, I had a letter from him this morning and he reckons he's coming back in the city to live.
I believe he's back already. Mrs. Powell saw his son moving him in this morning.
Back already?
Well, apparently. No.
Well, look, there's a terrible lot of work to be done around the garden. He's got wonderful green fingers. I'm wondering if, you know, he could fix up a few jobs around here.
Well, I'm sorry to disappoint you, Lizzie, but there simply isn't the money at the moment.
But you get a lot of money from the government, don't you?
Unfortunately, I have to keep to a budget, and the department is always trying to cut it back.
Oh, the miserable... Sorry, Mrs. Davidson.
Besides, Lizzie, you must remember that Sid had a stroke and we really don't know how fit he is.
Yeah. Well, do you reckon I could go out and then I could find out how he is?
Well, I suppose it might be possible.
Tomorrow?
I'll have to clear it with the department, but there shouldn't be any problems.
Oh, you are a good sort, Mrs. Davidson.
Mrs. Power can escort you.
Beauty!
Lizzie, why wouldn't you talk in front of Mr. Fletcher?
Oh, well, you know, me and Sid, it's not the sort of thing you talk about in front of men.
Oh, of course. How silly of me.
No sign of Doreen. She must have copped it.
Well, then where's Laurie?
Don't know. But Davo wouldn't put them both in the pound.
I wouldn't put it past her.
Trust Doreen to stuff things up.
He's home. He's back in his own house, and I'm gonna see him.
Who's back?
Sid. Mrs. Powell saw him moving back into his house this morning, and he's all right.
Oh, when are you gonna see him?
Oh, tomorrow at his place. Isn't it just wonderful?
It's terrific.
What's going on here? Get back to work. Rack
off. Just celebrating my good news, Miss Bennet.
Oh, yes, and what's that?
Sid Humphrey. I'm gonna visit him. Mrs. Davidson arranged it special.
Just make sure that you're back on time.
You're the only person I know who could find a cow pat at the end of a rainbow.
That's enough. Or you'll find yourself in solitary with Burns.
Aha! So, she's in the pound, eh?
Yes. She's swapped with your little friend, Young.
And Laurie?
She's in her cell. Now get back to work.
Oh, you're right, little bag!
Well, come on, smile. Won't crack your face, you know.
I just don't know what I'm going to say to her.
About what?
Bennet. She's told her.
About you?
That bitch.
Wonder how she's gonna react. It's not every day you find out your mother's a lesbian. Hi.
Hello, Mum.
How was it in there?
Oh, got to me a bit. Well, not knowing what to expect, I mean. I suppose I panicked. I don't know that I could have stood another day.
You would have got used to it.
Yeah. What made it worse was that maniac that put me in there. Screaming, yelling. I just got all keyed up.
Laura. Whatever happens, you mustn't let her get to you.
I won't.
She's weird, that one. I think she likes hurting people. Gets a kick out of it.
And she hurt you?
She tried to. She said things to me about you.
And that hurt, huh?
A bit, I suppose. It was the way she said them as much as anything. I told her that I already knew. And that it didn't matter.
And does it?
No.
How did you find out, Laura? Who told you?
Nobody told me. I suppose I just guessed. I mean, well, Sharon, you must have really loved her to get yourself put in here.
I did.
Now that I know, there's something that I still don't understand. Where do I fit in?
When I was younger, I was pretty naive. I knew that I was happier in the company of women, but I didn't know it could ever be more than friendship, you see. Anyway, I met this wonderful person. She was a school teacher, and, well, everybody found out, and there was a huge scandal, and she killed herself. That's when I decided to come to Australia, because I just had to know. I had to know, was I sick? Was I different? I met your father then. He was a nice man. He was gentle. And I became pregnant with you.
Well, what happened to him?
Well, I got pregnant. He got lost.
Did you love him?
I loved you, Laura. I met a girl then called Angela, and it was like going home after being away for a long time. But I thought it wasn't right to bring you up in that atmosphere. See how things have changed now? It's different. Oh, Laura, do you really think it's all right?
I've got some friends on the outside, some guys. Well, they're that way. And they're really nice. They treat me well, and, you know, they're not after the same old thing. And there's a woman, a friend of theirs. She tried to put the hard word on me once. I told her no. Nicely. But she didn't really want to take no for an answer. I told her I didn't mind what she did with other people. But I just wasn't that way myself.
Well, I'm glad.
Why?
Because life isn't so easy for people like me. People aren't very tolerant.
They're stupid, then. Look, what does it matter where you find love? As long as you find it.
You don't mind, then, if I hold you sometime? Because I'm so proud of you. And I love you very much.
Why should I mind? You're my mother.
Oh. I was hoping I wouldn't see you again.
No, it hasn't been heard yet. The other two cases took too long.
Oh, good. I thought for a minute that you'd copped a sentence.
My hearing's been set for tomorrow.
Right.
So there's still time to find that witness.
Well, I wish I could help.
But you see...
I'll have to work a bit later tonight.
But you promised.
I can't change the roster.
You're just like all the rest.
I've tried. There's nothing else I can do. I'm sorry.
Thank you. How do I look?
Terrific.
Oh, good. I'm all fingers and thumbs.
Yeah.
All right, Lizzie. I'm not ready.
Oh, yes, you are.
Well, first time you've been out since...
you went over the wall.
It's nice to be going out real legal. Oh, I've got... oh, it's just a little housewarming present for him. Can I?
Shouldn't you be at work?
I've got another half hour, yeah?
No, I think you should. Oh, yeah, well, I need to have a look at the press anyway. Good luck, love.
Thank you, Bea.
Lizzie, I don't want you to get your hopes up too high. Sid's
what
had a very
mean?
Bad stroke. Look, he's
Has anything
all right.
Happened since?
No, but he's not completely recovered yet.
Well, I know that.
Yes, but he may not be as well as you seem to think.
But if he can manage and if he's in the house...
He can manage, but simple things.
Oh, who's going to look after him? Who's going to take care of him?
I've got a key to the house. I'll check on him from time to time.
Oh, you got me real worried now. Can we get going?
Don't forget this.
Oh, dear.
Yeah. Good morning. Morning, Julie.
Morning.
Just sign out, Lizzie. Thanks.
G'day.
Hi.
Lizzie. No chance of another postponement?
No. It will be heard today.
Right. Well, good luck.
Yeah.
Hey, come on. Even if the worst comes to the worst, you can always appeal.
Why bother?
Well, give you more time. Try and find that witness.
Time. Yeah. That's the trouble.
Well, as always, next year's team.
It's not like that in this game. You reach a peak. You're ready to take on the whole world. You know when you're at your best. And that time's now for me. Next year, there'll be some other young kid who's at her best and... Ah, what's the use?
Sorry, Jim, she'll be late.
Yeah, well, I'll keep my fingers crossed.
Yeah, terrific.
Of all those that come in here saying they're innocent, she's one, I believe.
Mm. Right, Lizzie.
I know what you mean.
Come on. Sid? You here? Sid?
Coming.
Sid.
Hello, Elizabeth.
I thought you said...
That takes time, Lizzie, a lot of time.
Bit of a mess, don't I? Still, no worries. Now that you're here, I'm feeling better already.
Oh, Sid. Oh, it's terrible, the mess they've left everything. They must have been animals.
Well, might have started. Should have seen the kitchen before.
Other people's property. They should have had more respect. They ought to be locked away.
That's a joke coming from you.
Yeah, I'm a fine one to talk, aren't I? Still, I'd like to get my hands on the buggers that lived here.
You'll want a cup of tea.
I'll fix it.
No, I'll do it. You sit down. Yeah, it was nice of Mrs. Powell to... leave us alone. Give us a bit of time to ourselves.
Yeah, she's not a bad old stick for a screw. Here, let...
No. I can manage. Well, I've got to do it. I've got to learn.
Yeah, but when there's no need...
You know, I'm almost glad about the mess they left this place in.
Glad?
Gives me something to do. Something to work for.
Yeah, but there's no need when you're not well enough.
Well, I haven't done too bad a job in here.
Those curtains need fixing, but I can do that.
Thank you, Elizabeth, but you done quite enough for me already.
Me?
What have I done?
Oh, gave me a kick up the pants when I needed it. Stopped me feeling sorry for myself when all I wanted to do was give up.
Oh, that was nothing.
Yeah, to you, maybe. Everything in the world to me. And your letters, full of hope, life. Just what I needed. Well, there. Told you I could manage.
I'm real proud of you, Sid. Aren't you going to light the gas?
The whole truth, nothing but the truth, so help me God.
Would you state your name and occupation?
Detective Sergeant Davison, Surrey Hills Breaking and Entering Squad.
You are the arresting officer?
That is correct.
Well, if you would tell us in your own words what happened on the evening of the 27th that led to the arrest.
At about 7:15 p.m. we received a call from the offices of G.C. Wilkins, former employers of the accused. Apparently there had been a burglary.
Apparently?
We were not able to establish the facts until we arrived. The safe had clearly been rifled, and it was stated that a sum of $8,000 had been taken.
Was there any sign of forced entry into the building?
There was not.
So that suggested that it was an inside
job. Objection. Leading the witness.
Sustained.
What conclusions did you draw from the fact that there was no sign of forced entry?
That it was an inside job.
Proceed.
The burglar alarm had been switched off, the safe unlocked, not picked or broken into. The owner informed us that three members of the staff had keys or access to them. Of those three people, only the accused did not have an alibi for her whereabouts at the time of the crime.
I don't believe we have established what that time was.
An electric wall clock was wired to the same circuit as the burglar alarm, which, as I said, had been switched off. The clock had therefore stopped, showing the time as 6:27.
Proceed.
Was the safe checked for fingerprints?
Yes, those of the accused were found on it.
Were they the most recent ones?
This could not be established. Further investigation revealed that the accused had an argument with her employer a week before the crime and was dismissed.
She handed in the keys when she left.
Yes, but it would have been a simple matter for her to have had a copy made of them.
Your Honour, the judge realises the objection.
The jury will ignore the last remark.
But it is possible she could have had a copy made from the key or keys.
Yes, sir.
Have you any evidence that she did so?
No, sir.
Thank you. That is all.
You may stand down. The court is adjourned for lunch.
All rise.
Here we are, boss lady.
Oh, you're back. You're pretty chirpy this morning.
Yeah, well, I got something to be chirpy about.
Didn't feel like that last night.
I've told Laurie everything, and she understands.
Everything? Oh. She's not,
No, she's not. She just understands, that's all.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's hard to tell with a name like Laurie. It makes her sound a bit like a truck driver. Anyway, she's a cute kid. How old is she?
She's nearly 21.
Yeah, when?
Next week.
Well, why didn't you say so? Hey, Laurie, is that true? You've got a birthday coming up.
Yeah, next week.
Well, there's cause for celebration. I mean, a girl's got to have a party for her 21st birthday.
In here?
Well, we do have birthdays too, you know.
Oh, would they let us?
Yeah, of course they would.
Oh, I doubt it.
Oh, come on now. She's your long-lost kid. She's almost made it to 21. And if I've ever heard an excuse for a party, that's it. All those in favour, raise your hands. Yeah. Harry.
There. That's a bit better.
My word.
Now, I'm starving. How about a spot of dinner?
Well, there's not a lot.
You're flaming right, there's not. What was you going to eat, Sid?
I'd have found something.
Yeah?
Yeah, my son says he'll drop some stuff off, and Mrs. Powell says she'll go shopping for me. Not that I'd like to ask.
Why not?
Well, She's got enough to do, working, a family to run.
Oh, she wouldn't mind. She wouldn't have offered if she had. You got to eat, Sid.
Oh, don't get that hungry these days.
Have you ever heard of them Meals on Wheels? Save you a lot of bother.
I'm not having them.
Well, it's real nice food.
I'm not having charity.
Oh, you give me the screaming irrits sometimes, Sid Humphrey. It's not charity. You got to pay for it. It's not much money.
Yeah, well, call it what you like. I don't want it.
Look how long it took you to make a cup of tea. Now, if you had your midday meal delivered, you could spend all the more time on the house.
Yeah, well, there is that, I suppose.
And you don't mind me fixing your tucker.
Well, it's different.
No, it's not. Well, I suppose it is in a way. You promise me you'll think about it?
Yeah, all right. I'll think about it.
Well, that's all right then. I'll just see what I can make out of this lot.
Excuse me. Do you know if Miss Humber's home? Do you know where she is?
What are you talking about? Today it was good.
Young, could I have a word with you, please?
What's it about?
It's nothing to worry about, Judy.
No, but I would like...
I'm sorry. Shall we go inside? What's all this about?
Well, your sentence hearing isn't for another week, but I've done your pre-sentence report, which I hope will persuade the judge to be lenient, but a lot will depend on you.
How?
Well, before he passes sentence, the judge will ask you if you've anything to say. Mm. Now, if you're aggressive, he will be too.
You mean I should lick his boots?
No, no, that's not what I meant.
Well, what then?
Well, try and be yourself. Tell him how much being with your mother meant to you. And I think you've got a good chance of getting a light sentence, maybe even a suspended one. And then you'll be free.
But my mother wouldn't be, would she?
No, not for quite some time, but... Well, that's what I meant when I said it's up to you. If you offend the judge, you could get a heavy sentence. Now, is that what you want?
Well, can't you see? I had to come and visit her. I had to find out what she was like and... Well, why she did what she did. It was worth everything to me. I think I know who I am now.
Do you want to stay here?
No. Not now that I know. There's no need. Oh, look, not that I regret it, any of it. It's just that I know that Mum would be happier if I was free on the outside.
Well, she's right.
So, I'll do anything you want.
Good.
What do you think will happen to me?
I don't know. But I'll do everything I can to help.
Thanks, Mrs. Morris.
Right. You can go back to work now.
And the accused was employed by you?
Yes.
Why did you dismiss her?
Well, it was all this running. I mean, I'm as keen on physical fitness as the next man, but you can't let it interfere with business. If only she'd been reasonable. But it was an hour off here, 2 hours there, out of all proportion. I spoke to her about it, and all I got was cheek in return. Well, you can't let the staff walk all over you, can you? But I'd been fair. I gave her 3 warnings, and after that I had no choice. She had to go.
And what was her reaction to this dismissal?
Oh, very angry. Cheeky, too. She said she'd get back at me for it one day.
She didn't indicate how she might achieve this.
No, but I wasn't long finding out, was I?
And up until this time, you had trusted her?
I'd always thought of her as a very honest girl. Well, I gave her a key to the safe.
How much was taken from the safe?
8,000, give or take a dollar or two.
Isn't that rather a large amount to keep on the premises?
Well, perhaps, but I've got this restaurant. It's not doing too well, and I find it hard to get credit. I need that amount of money to pay the bills. You see, restaurants need a large cash flow, and if you can't get credit, well... But if I'd thought for a minute, she always seemed such a nice girl, apart from the running.
Thank you.
Oh, you're always saying that I can't keep away from the place.
No, I had to come back and get my running gear. Left it in the staff room.
Yes, you're really getting super fit, aren't you?
Oh, no, it's just a run. Anyway, I thought I'd have another crack at trying to find this missing witness for Michelle Parks.
Ah, yes, this famous little old lady.
Yeah, well, you never
know.
Well,
the hearing's today, isn't it?
Yeah, but just in case she has to appeal. Anyway, I like the running.
Yes, well, I can see that by the state of your shoes. Whew.
What's wrong with them?
Well, they're practically falling apart.
Well, they're very comfortable. I've had them a long time.
Yes, we'll make the most of them. They're not going to last much longer.
Mm. Well, it'll be a sad day when I have to ditch these and buy a new pair, I can tell you.
Oh, they're beautiful. I'm going to put them in water straight away.
Their garden's a bit overgrown, but I'll soon have it right.
Oh, as long as you don't overdo it, that's all.
I told you. I know my limits these days. Anyway, I haven't really got much choice.
Sid, don't you reckon that you should be staying with your son? I mean, you'd be looked after proper.
This is my house, my home. This is where I live, and this is where I want to die.
Oh, don't talk like that.
I'm not being gloomy. It happens to us all.
Oh, you've got a lot of time left yet.
Time I started facing a few facts. Besides, you've been happy here today, haven't you?
Oh, yeah. It's been wonderful, Sid.
Wouldn't be the same at Gordon's place. Couldn't be by ourselves.
Well, as long as you're well enough, that's all.
Well, put it this way. I'd rather have a short, happy life than a long, miserable one, wouldn't you? Anyway, no way I'm going to give up. Not with your visits to look forward to. You will come again.
If you want me to.
Hope I'm not interrupting.
Well, you are, as a matter of fact.
Now, Elizabeth, she's got her job to do.
And it is time to go back, I'm afraid, Lizzie.
Already? But
it's
I'm
after
just...
four.
Cool. I thought I'd only been here a few minutes.
Well, I'll give you a minute to say goodbye. I'll be outside, Lizzie.
Now, I've got to organise a bit of tucker, and I'll get Lizzie to make a home brew. Oh. Well, what's a party without a bit of booze, eh?
Oh, if it doesn't kill us.
Oh, right. Look, I don't want to spoil the fun, but if what Mrs. Morris says is true, I could be out of here before my birthday.
I wouldn't count your chickens, though.
But she said that
now,
I'd probably be
right,
able to
love.
Get...
You see, in a place like this, it's best not to count on anything until it happens.
You mean I might have to stay?
Would that be so bad?
No, of course not. Well, you know how much I wanted to be
I
with
know
you.
That, but you want to be free, too. And I want that for you more than anything.
Yeah, anyway, we can have a party a couple of days early. What the hell? Yeah, tell you what, why don't we make it a fancy dress term? We've never had one.
Yes.
And there's all that stuff left over from the panto.
Would they leave us?
Well, like I told you, just leave it to me. Okay, you lot, come on, back to work. We don't want to give them any excuse for spoiling our bit of fun now, do we?
No.
Come on,
okay.
Step two.
Okay.
Yeah? Gives them all something to look forward to, ain't you?
So even though you deny all the charges against you, you cannot prove where you were on the night in question.
I told you, I was at a party. Lots of people saw me there.
Oh, later, yes, but not between the hours of 6 and 7, the actual time of the robbery.
I was training. I always run then.
Oh, as Mr. Lawrence has testified. Yet we have no proof that you were training on this particular night. No one saw you.
Lots of people run.
You had the motive and opportunity to commit the robbery. I think you'll agree that it is rather unfortunate that no one saw you.
There was someone, an old lady in the park.
Ah, yes, the mysterious old lady. Yet the police, despite intensive inquiries, have found no trace of this mysterious lady.
Maybe they didn't look hard enough. There were lots of people in the park.
But not one of them can remember you. And why can no one remember you? I suggest it is because you were not there.
No!
That because of your regular and well-known training habits, you thought you were quite safe in going to your place of former employment, of using a copy of the key you had made before your dismissal to open the safe and take the money to spite your former employer.
It isn't true.
And I further submit that the reason this lady cannot be found is because she doesn't exist. And I submit that you are guilty of the charges against you.
Come on. Did he like his present?
I didn't give it to him.
Why not?
It was a tie. He wouldn't been able to put it on proper. You will look after him, won't you?
I promised I would.
Oh,
I'd give anything to be out of here looking after him myself. See if you can talk him into them meals on wheels. He seemed to be coming around to the idea.
I'll do my best.
Me stuck in here, not being able to help. Oh, you will see him every day. Let me know how he's going.
Lizzie.
I know I'm a pain in the neck, but I've got to make sure he's all right. You know what I mean?
The evidence you've heard in this case against the accused is mostly circumstantial. You have to decide what you prefer to believe. Her claim that she was elsewhere at the time in question, although no witnesses have been found to verify this, or the proven fact that she had the opportunity, the motive, and the ability to commit this crime. You've heard a witness state that it is not in her character to commit a crime. You may believe this, but you must also remember that the witness in question has only known the accused for a very short space of time. The testified fact that she habitually went running between the hours of 6 and 7 p.m. does not necessarily prove that she did so on this particular occasion. You must also remember that the physical appearance, the potential ability, and the previous good character of this woman does nothing to lessen the magnitude of the crime for which she has been charged.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too. Around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare.